SCTV Network production.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Starting here late in the MSAC United Champions, we have the first girls' consolation game between South Charleston and GW. A nice rivalry game here as South Charleston won the tip off. Their first shot is no good. GW the other way. A fight for it. Aaliyah Dunham steals it away. Back up court. It's 2-1-2. She goes in for the layup. That is good. First points of the game go to South Charleston. That shot is blocked by Reyes Smith. Nice block there by the senior center. To inbound it. To Self. Corner three. Rolls in. That is good. Aaliyah Dunham up the other way. Gets it to Rhea Smith. She'll shoot a three. She'll make a three. 5-3 for the Black Eagles now against their bitter rivals, the GW Patriots. That easy layup. Wow, that's a wide open pass. Easy layup for GW. And South Charleston quickly calls a timeout here. So our apologies for the late start here. This is the first of four games we have. First of four games we have in the MSAC Night of Champions. Second one coming up is the boys' consolation game between Huntington and Woodrow Wilson. Then comes the girls' MSAC championship. That'll be between the Huntington Highlanders and the Parkersburg Big Reds. And then at the end of the game, the biggest game of the night, that'll be the South Charleston Black Eagles versus the Capital Cougars, a rematch of the MSAC Conference Championship 2 years ago and the regular season victory over South Charleston that Capital had this year. Underway we go, Aaliyah Dunham with it. Out to Lavender Ward. Now to Rhea Smith. Rhea Smith, long two, that's no good. So GW Patriots get it back. This is Sydney Mallory to inbound. Tied 5-5 to Darnell, back to Self. Up the middle, that's intercepted by Haley Baker. Aaliyah Dunham back with it the other way. Lavender Ward now up the middle to Rhea Smith. She almost lost it. She tries to, and she gets it to Haley Baker, that she scores. So several ties and several lead changes here to begin the game. Self gets it up the middle now to Sydney Mallory. That is intercepted once again by Haley Baker on the fast break. It's 2-1-2. She'll drive it in herself. Now out to Lavender Ward. Now to Rhea Smith. Rhea Smith pressured. She gets it to Aaliyah Dunham. Right wing to Ward. Now to Rhea Smith. She almost lost that one. She gets it back to Lavender Ward. Passing around this, Jayla Brown back to Aaliyah Dunham. Aaliyah Dunham with it. She'll try to drive in the travel. No, push off. So Sydney Mallory committed that foul, and Aaliyah Dunham will pass this one in. That's the first foul of the game. Rhea Smith back with it now to Jayla Brown. To Lavender Ward now to Jayla Brown. Up the middle to Rhea Smith, excuse me. Her layup is good. Biggest lead of the night for either team. It's 9-5. Gets it to Self. Now to up the middle. That's a long three, actually. And that is good. So that was a long two. 9-7. That was Kaylee Barnell for the GW Patriots. Lavender Ward drives in. With a nice spin move, that teardrop shot is no good. Rebounded by Self. So now Self has it, excuse me. Sydney Mallory with it. She passes it to the right, back to Mallory. She'll drive in for two. That's no good. And Jayla Brown gets it back. Aaliyah Dunham the other way. Haley Baker back with it. Haley Baker, long two is no good, but she is fouled on the shot. Going to the line, 4-2. Haley Baker going to the line for two. These are the first foul shots of the game. Her shot is good. 3-point lead back for the Black Eagles, and two substitutions coming in. One on both teams. Shea Watts comes in for Rhea Smith. Her second shot bouncing around, no good. GW gets it back. 10-7. Around the perimeter, GW goes. Wide open shooter we have, and she does not score on that one. That goes out of bounds off of GW. And George Washington will take a timeout here. And with that, we will take a timeout of our own. This is the RSN Network, hosted by the NFHS Network.
Just cause it don't look like a restaurant, Schmiskit time.
Dude, it's midnight.
24/7 style.
Time to cook up some apps.
Oh no, she didn't.
And she had the nerve to speak to me.
Yes, she.
Mac and cheese for me.
Touch the screen. Ah. Get the awesome food.
So Aaliyah Dunham back with it after the timeout by GW. Largest lead of the game is Smith. Ooh, nice play fake there by South Charleston. Fake the reverse, Aaliyah Dunham. Ooh, Aaliyah Dunham almost stole that one away from Self. Aaliyah Dunham faked the reverse there, wide open layup. And she scores. It's now 12-7, Black Eagles in the battle for third place in the conference, and that is intercepted. Haley Baker tipped it, and it was intercepted by Lavender Ward. Haley Baker is fat. No, she traveled. They call a travel on here. So after a GW turnover, it's a South Charleston turnover. Passing around the perimeter is GW now into the middle, and she. See what they call here. Reach in foul, South Charleston. That was 41, Shea Watts on the foul by South Charleston. That is almost intercepted, but they get it out. Top of the key, now to the left. Quick passes by GW around the perimeter. She'll drive in for two. That teardrop shot, no good. Haley Baker rebounds. Now to Aaliyah Dunham. Leah Dunham participated in the three-point contest today. Haley Baker also participated in the top shooting competition. Now Haley Baker has it. She tries to fake the reverse. That's tipped by GW, and that goes out of bounds off the foot of Haley Baker. Another South Charleston turnover. That's a second and two possessions. So GW gets it back. They're passing around the perimeter once again. Now to the top of the key. Now to the left. She'll shoot a three. That is no good. A fight for the rebound of Shayla Watts wins for South Charleston. Rhea Smith about to come back into the game for South Charleston. Aaliyah Dunham looking for someone. Aaliyah Dunham is fouled on that shot and she makes it. But they're going to call reach in. She says she was not in the shooting motion. And in for South Charleston is number 22, Rhea Smith. Out is number 24, Lavender Ward. So Haley Baker will inbound. Trying to set up a play to South Charleston. They need to get it out. They do. Aaliyah Dunham sidesteps. Now gives it to Haley Baker. Into Rhea Smith. Now to Shea Watts. Shea Watts has trouble with it, but she scores. Largest lead of the night for South Charleston. It's 14-7. 2:10 left in the game here in the battle for third place in the girls' consolation game at the MSAC Night of Champions. They'll drive into the paint now out to the right wing. That is almost intercepted. Not quite. Way out on the right wing now, across, pass across the key. Long three. That is no good. And a fight for the rebound. Aaliyah Dunham with it. Aaliyah Dunham gets it out to Jayla Brown. Jayla Brown will shoot a three and make a three. 10-point lead for the Black Eagles now. It's 17-7. Right side three is no good. GW got the rebound, and then she was fouled on the shot. That's Kaylee Darnell that got fouled. Jayla Brown was the fouler. This is GW's first free throw attempts of the night. Shot is up and good. And a substitution for South Charleston, number 33, as Olivia Jeffries coming in for number 41, Shea Watts. Second shot is good, it's 17-9. Leah Dunham, and hey, we have whistles here. Looks like we have to have a substitution in for GW. And we have two GW players heading into the locker room, so looks like Tori Self heading to the locker room for GW. Now Jayla Brown wide open too. That is no good. And the rebound is controlled by GW. GW to the right. Now at the top of the key. Now way out in the right wing. That is no good. And that is, wow, nice save there by GW, but not very good ball handling. They turn it over. South Charleston the other way. 47 seconds left to go in this first quarter. Now to Rhea Smith. Rhea Smith through the contact is fouled. Lauren Harmakin, second personal foul. She fouled Rhea Smith, and she'll go to the line for two. She has 5 points so far tonight. And it will remain five as she misses the first foul shot of the night for her. Lavender Ward in for Jayla Brown now for South Charleston. Rhea Smith's shot is good. 18-9 now for the Black Eagles. Right wing. Now top of the key. She's almost pressured by Lavender Ward. That ball goes out of bounds off of GW. So South Charleston gets it back after another turnover. Leah Dunham receiving a play from South Charleston head coach John Testa. Leah Dunham, GW bringing on the pressure here. Back to Leah Dunham. Ooh, nice crossover. And she is fouled on that shot, but no call, and GW gets it back. She fought through a lot of contact there. No call. Three from GW. That is no good, and that is the end of the first quarter. So South Charleston controlling this one fairly well early. It's 18-9 after the first quarter of this girls' consolation game. This is the RSN Sports Network. We'll be right back.
This is a SCTV Network production.
While I'm waiting on spring to get here, there's three things I do to pass the time. Trying to figure out why they put an extra R in February. Give my sweetheart an assorted box of fried chicken gizzards. Check out a new pickup during Ram Truck Month.
At Dutch Miller Ram of South Charleston, get a 2015 Ram 1500 Crew Cab Express 4x4, starting at just $239 a month.
Only at the home of friends and family pricing for everyone, Dutch Miller Ram of South Charleston.
Welcome back to the South Charleston Community Center. This is the MSAC Night of Champions brought to you by the RSN Sports Network. We are currently in, actually starting the second quarter of the girls' consolation game in the battle for third place against bitter rivals South Charleston and George Washington. South Charleston won the matchup earlier in the year in the regular season by a pretty much a blowout margin as GW was without their star center, Shy Banks, as she, not Shy Banks, but GW is fouled on that shot. They'll go to the line for two. Shy Banks also inactive tonight. She's not even on the roster here, so see how GW can perform against their bitter rival. Third and fourth foul shots for George Washington. They are 50% so far in the night. That is good. At the line is number 44, Lauren Harmison. Second shot is up and good. 18-11 is the deficit for George Washington. Aaliyah Dunham now with it. Getting a play from John Testa. And fakes the reverse again to Haley Baker. Now she does pass it to Haley Baker. Now to Lavender Ward. Lavender Ward will try to drive in. And her layup is no good. And then she gets her own rebound back and scores. 20 to 11 now for the Black Eagles. Passing around the perimeter is GW. Long pass. She gets a crossover there, but her shot is no good. Rhea Smith on the rebound. She gets it to Aaliyah Dunham. Aaliyah Dunham trying to make something happen. Lavender Ward now. Lavender Ward now to Rhea Smith. Back to Lavender Ward. That teardrop shot is good. Double-digit lead for the Black Eagles. It's 22-11 now. Still passing around the perimeter is GW. They excel when they can get a wide open three. That's usually where the majority of their points come from. Not so much luck so far tonight. Long pass. Sydney Mallory is pressured. And South Charleston forces the turnover. Aaliyah Dunham on the fast break. It's one-on-one. Her layup is good. Good for the Xavier commit. Aaliyah Dunham, 24-11 now. And that is, wow, intercepted by Lavender Ward, and she almost gets it poked away. That was a bad pass there. Now to Rhea Smith. Rhea Smith now to Jayla Brown. Jayla Brown's layup is no good, and Aaliyah Dunham gets the rebound back. Now to Haley Baker. Haley Baker will shoot a three. Got stuck in between the uprights. That's not very often you see that one, but happens once a year. It's pretty funny every time it happens. So Shea Watts comes in for Rhea Smith. And they will try to poke this one out, and they do. Number 14, Corey Self returns. Jump ball possession to South Charleston. That'll give the possession to South Charleston. Jayla Brown will inbound this one. Now to Lavender Ward. Lavender Ward into Shea Watts. The big center is blocked. The other way goes McMillan. And almost intercepted now to... Yes, Tori Self. Excuse me, that was Kaylee Darnell for the two. 24-13 now for the Patriots. Or for the Black Eagles, excuse me. That is a deficit for the Patriots. Pass to Haley Baker. Haley Baker will drive in for two. They got a hand on it. That's no good. So GW looking to make a run happen here. They'll get it to Sydney Mallory. Sydney Mallory fouled hard. She'll inbound. Aaliyah Dunham was the fouler there. Sydney McMillan gets it into Darnell. Sydney Mallory back with it. Almost went backcourt. Passing around the perimeter still is GW. They get one into the paint. Long two has no good, and let's see who controls the rebound here. GW got it, but they went out of bounds. That was Sydney Mallory, so South Charleston gets the ball back. And in for South Charleston is number 33, Olivia Jeffries. In for number 11, Haley Baker. Aaliyah Dunham. Seems like GW will try to press her. Aaliyah Dunham, they will. Half court press. Top of the key to board. Now to Shayla Watts. She's got the height advantage, but it is blocked. 2-on-1. Now the South Charleston defense catches up. Wide open three. Top of the key. That is no good. GW gets their own rebound, and now South Charleston does. Lavender Ward, fast break, but she'll back off. Aaliyah Dunham was wide open. She'll shoot a three. She'll make a three. You cannot do that for Aaliyah Dunham. Leave her wide open. It's 27-13 for the Black Eagles. That is almost intercepted by Dunham. Long two. That is more or less a pass to their teammate. Olivia Jeffries on the interception. Fast break. It's 2-1-2. Aaliyah Dunham will go in for the layup. She is fouled. Nice drawing the foul there by Aaliyah Dunham. Sydney Mallory was the fouler there. So Aaliyah Dunham will go to the line. Her first shots of the night. So Dunham's first shot is up. No good. And Rhea Smith will check into the game. And out comes number 41, Shay Watts. There's also a substitution for GW. That was number 21 as Aaliyah Dunham's second shot is up and good. Number 21, Faith Thompson in for number 3, Sydney Mallory. Right wing. She'll shoot a three. That is not good. And the other way, Lavender Ward right up the middle. She scores and is fouled. So she'll go to the free throw line for the and one shot here. That shot is no good. South Charleston gets their own rebound, though. Rhea Smith with it. She is blocked. And her second shot is also no good. GW back with it. So 30-13 now for the Black Eagles. They're starting to open this one up a little bit. What can GW do against their rifle? Long three, no good. Aaliyah Dunham on the rebound. Haley Baker's about to come back into the game for South Charleston. Lots of substitutions by John Testa. Jayla Brown draws the contact there as her shot is no good, but she'll go to the line for two more. So, Jayla Brown's first shot is good. And a substitution for the George Washington Patriots. Number 40, Kim Carney comes out for number 44, Lauren Harmison. Exchange of centers there. So, Jayla Brown on her second attempt is good. Ooh, and Rhea Smith goes down. Not sure what happened there. She gets back up, though. 32-13. 19-point lead already for the Black Eagles, as this is starting to look like a mirror image of the regular season matchup between the two teams, in which South Charleston won 68-41. GW tries to draw the contact, but no good. Aaliyah Dunham with it. Haley Baker, she'll try a long two. That is no good. GW gets the rebound. Passing around the perimeter once again. Thompson now to self. Trying to shot the middle. Rhea Smith on the block. Aaliyah Dunham. Three people just went down. Not sure what they call here. Aaliyah Dunham's in some pain there. And they'll just call a blocking foul on GW. Number 22, Rhea Smith, is out for South Charleston. In comes number 33, Olivia Jeffries. So Aaliyah Dunham, they say she was in the shooting motion. She'll shoot for two here. Attempt to make this a 20-point lead. That is no good. So actually, South Charleston in the bonus here. They'll drive in for two. That is no good. So GW has not been able to hit many shots in the past four possessions. Aaliyah Dunham, on the crossover is no good. And Shea Watts will come in for Olivia Jeffries. That'll go out of bounds off of South Charleston, so GW to inbound this one. This is Faith Thompson. McMillan with it. Gets to Thompson. Back to Thompson. That is intercepted by Lavender Ward. Fast break. That shot is good. 21-point lead here for the Black Eagles. 34-13, under 2 minutes left to go here in the first half. Not a lot of competition for the Black Eagles so far. That long three is good. Just as I said something. GW makes their first shot in five possessions. It's a three, 34-16. Aaliyah Dunham's shot is no good, and GW gets it back. And Aaliyah Dunham pokes it away, and a Lavender Ward now with it. Now to Aaliyah Dunham, she sidesteps. So again to the paint, now to Haley Baker. That three is good. 37-16 with 1:14 left to go in this half. Wide open, that's a long two, that's no good. Lavender Ward back with it. Aaliyah Dunham up the court, 1 minute left. Jayla Brown, wide open layup. Not a lot of fight there by the GW defense. It's 39-16, 47 seconds left. Out the middle, that is, she had trouble with the ball. And Olivia Jeffries will come in for South Charleston, and out comes number 24, Lavender Ward. Excuse me, no, Aaliyah Dunham comes out for South Charleston. So the ball went out of bounds off of South Charleston. GW will get this one. That is intercepted, wide open is Lavender Ward. That layup is good, 41-16. 32 seconds left as GW trying to get something to happen here. They're known for their three-point shots, and here comes another one. That is no good. That's been the story for GW, not being able to hit those long-range shots, and that is why they trail big here. 12 seconds left. They're just going to try to hold on to this one for the last shot. Jayla Brown, 5 seconds. Jayla Brown for three, that is no good. So at the end of the first half, South Charleston with a huge lead over their battle rivals, the GW Patriots, 41-16. So the story of this game so far, South Charleston with their rebounds, they had 18 just in the first half, and GW not being able to score on their long range shots, which is usually what they try for, not going very well, and they trail by a huge margin, 41-16. We will be right back after halftime. Please stay tuned. This is the MSAC Night of Champions, broadcasted by the RSN Sports Network.
This is a SCTV Network production.
Now you can create your own tour of Italy from Olive Garden's most mouth-watering dishes, starting at $12.99. Choose 3 of 10 classic favorites to enjoy on one plate, like our delicious new shrimp ravioli with lobster alfredo, a filled pasta like irresistible tortellini al forno, and a classic like creamy fettuccine alfredo, plus unlimited salad and freshly baked breadsticks. Because the best tour of Italy is the one you create, only at Olive Garden. We're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. Breadstick sandwiches.
William Shakespeare said that all the world's a stage, and men and women are merely players. But Mr. Shakespeare never met Stephen Curry. Nihao, the guy who's in the gym every dang day. Patriot saint of the underdog, the league's most unguardable player. Bang, he knocks it down. So my apologies to Mr. Shakespeare, because onto the stage of mere players enters the babyface assassin. And he's about to write his own story. Fall back.
SCTV Network Production. Thank you.
NFHS Network event is brought to you by Cricket Wireless. Now that's something to smile about.
This is a SCTV Network production.
This event is brought to you by Olive Garden. Olive Garden is proud to be the official dining room of high school sports. With menu choices to please the entire family, as well as to-go and catering options, it's the perfect restaurant for your post-game dining. To find your nearest location or to order your meal online, visit olivegarden.com.
The challenges facing the country.
Okay, welcome back to the South Charleston Community Center. South Charleston with a 41-16 lead over their rival GW, and we have South Charleston head coach John Testa. So coach, you're up 41-16 over your bitter rival in the consolation game. You've been able to out-rebound them. I believe you had 18-17 rebounds in the first half. They haven't been able to make their three, so are you? What's the strategy from here on out with this big lead?
Play 16 minutes like we just played that 16. We got a team rebound, get out on our shooters, and just keep running our system. We can't take them lightly right now. We've got to play for 16 more minutes.
Oh, yeah, because they really want to get back into this one, being down against their bitter rival.
Well, so we can do everything we can to keep them from getting back.
Keep pedal against the metal?
Yes, that's right.
All right, thank you, sir.
Yeah, I'm not John Testa.
You're Coach Green, my bad. All right. Coach Green from South Charleston Black Eagles will get back to you in this girls' consolation game. This is the RSN Sports Network.
This is a SCTV Network production.
Coaches teach your kids to dream. Coaches teach your kids to overcome. Coaches teach your kids good sportsmanship. Coaches teach your kids proper technique. But who teaches your coaches?
Dynamic Physical Therapy.
And welcome back to basketball action here in the girls' consolation game. You heard the coach. They're going to keep the pedal to the metal and keep playing like they did in the first half for 16 minutes. GW, however, with the first possession and the first score of the half, they're down 41-18. Passing around the perimeter is South Charleston. Haley Baker gets that one poked out. And possession to GW. Olivia Jeffries in for Haley Baker as she lost the ball out of bounds. And a quick little timeout to tie a shoe here. So GW with it, they're down about 23 points here to their bitter rival. Passing around the perimeter still is GW. Three from GW, that's McMillan, that's no good. But GW gets their own rebound back. Sydney Mallory decides not to shoot, and that pass is tipped. Aaliyah Dunham on the fast break, her layup is good. So 43-18 now for the Black Eagles. Teardrop shot, good for GW. 43-20 is the deficit now for the Patriots. And Haley Baker is about to be subbed into this game. Olivia Jeffries into Rhea Smith. Rhea Smith's layup is blocked, no good. On the fast break goes GW's McMillan. She's fouled on that shot, going to the line for two. So Coach Green for South Charleston, not Testa. Coach Green just mentioned keeping their pedal to the metal and keeping the same strategy that they've played the first 16 minutes. They're not going to take this one lightly, as GW obviously with some newfound life here, trying to get back into this game as their first free throw shot of the half is good. Olivia Jeffries comes out for South Charleston. good. 43-22 now for the Black Eagles. Haley Baker. Now to Lavender Ward. Now to Aaliyah Dunham. Aaliyah Dunham fakes the shot. Passing around the perimeter. Now inside. Jayla Brown good. Jayla Brown on the layup. 45-22 now as GW looking to make something happen. They've had some offensive success so far in the half. Not so much defense. Down the middle. Self drives in but gets her own rebound. And out of bounds on GW. No, out of bounds on South Charleston. Self will inbound this one. Olivia Jeffries coming back into the game. And Haley Baker back out of the game. So lots of substitutions here. That is intercepted by Aaliyah Dunham. No one is going to catch up to her. Wide open layup, 47-22 now for the Black Eagles. The game plan so far going as expected for the Black Eagles. And a travel. Sydney Mallory travels there, trying to get the pass off, and turnover. Another turnover by GW. Lee Dunham now to the left to Jayla Brown. Shea Watts about to come into this one. Aaliyah Dunham, now Jayla Brown. Up the middle to Olivia Jeffries. Her shot is no good. Rhea Smith gets it back and lays it in. 49-22 for the Black Eagles. More perimeter passing for GW. And Tori Self will shoot a three. She will not make a three. And a fight for the ball here. See who they give it to. And to South Charleston is the call. Shea Watts will come in. And Olivia Jeffries comes out. Aaliyah Dunham now with the ball. Now to Rhea Smith. Now into Shea Watts. Shea Watts is fouled and scores. And we'll go to the line for the end one shot. Shea Watts to go to the line for the extra shot, trying to make this a 30-point lead. She does not make it a 30-point lead, but Jayla Brown gets her own rebound. And Rhea's shot is blocked. Rhea Smith easily blocked by GW, but it goes out of bounds on GW. South Charleston will get this one back. Shea Watts now with it. Now to Rhea Smith. Rhea Smith shoots a three. She does not make a three. That is wildly missed. She has made a three. That was made in the first quarter. McMillan's backwards layup is no good. Aaliyah Dunham up the middle. She is fouled. Almost lost the ball there, but a reach and foul on the Patriots. They'll say she was in the shooting motion, so Aaliyah Dunham back to the line and some foul trouble actually for GW. Sydney Mallory has committed her fourth personal foul. So already some players in danger of fouling out for GW. Aaliyah's shot is up and good. And they will bring Sydney Mallory out of the game now as she is, like as I said, four personal fouls so far. 30-point lead now for the Black Eagles. That shot is no good. And GW the other way. Long three. No good off of the backboard. And they'll say GW was in the shooting motion on that one. And they'll go to the line for two. That's McMillan. Jayla Brown, number 23 for the Black Eagles, is the fouler on this play. That shot is good. Nice rainbow shot there by McMillan. Haley Baker about to come back into the game for South Charleston. Her second shot is good. And Haley Baker will come in for Jayla Brown. Baker will also inbound this ball. It's 52-24. Leah Dunham getting a play from Green. Now to Rhea Smith. Leah Dunham. She'll shoot a long two, then make one. 54-24 for the Black Eagles. GW back with it. They'll bring it out to their center. She'll shoot a three, but too much power on that one. Lavender Ward back with it. Now she does get it to Leah Dunham and scores. All falling apart for GW. It's 56-24, and this is just as tipped out of bounds by Leah Dunham. This is just the third quarter. There's 3:08 left to go in this quarter. Next game after this will be the boys' consolation game. And that is between the Huntington Highlanders and the Woodrow Wilson Flying Eagles, that is. About called them the Black Eagles there for a second. Both second place in the respective division. And they'll battle for third place. Long two, that is no good. And a Lavender Ward gets it back. Lavender Ward has made several good plays, including that one tonight. 58-24 for the South Charleston Black Eagles. Passing around the perimeter still, trying to get it open. Three. They'll shoot a three, does McMillan. That shot is no good, but GW gets it back and is fouled on the shot. So the towering center, Rhea Smith, is the fouler there. Katie Darnell will shoot two here. She makes her first. And Olivia Jeffries comes in for Rhea Smith. Trying to save some minutes and some foul trouble for the Black Eagles and Rhea Smith. That shot is no good. Shea Watts on the rebound. Haley Baker gets the long pass. Now to Lavender Ward. Wide open three. Makes it. Wow. What a game by Lavender Ward. 61-25 for the Black Eagles. And there's still an entire quarter to go after this. 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Nice step over there, but couldn't get the shot to go down. Olivia Jeffries with the ball. Now to Lavender Ward. Now to Leah Dunham. Leah Dunham to Ward. Now into Olivia Jeffries. She does not score, and GW controls the rebound. GW up the middle. Wide. Oh, no, she did not. She decided to drive in. She had a wide open field goal there. But she gets her own rebound and scores. Leah Dunham back with it. 1:26 left to go in the third quarter. South Charleston is up 61-27. Leah Dunham is pressured. Passing around the perimeter. Now into Shea Watts. Shea Watts out to a wide open Haley Baker. She'll drive in for two and is fouled. Nice strong contact there by Haley Baker. And they'll shoot two. 1:04 left to go in the quarter. So Haley Baker shooting her third or fourth. That is her third is good. Haley Baker on the second shot attempt. That is, bouncing around and good. GW definitely missing their star center, Shy Banks. She's inactive, not listed on the roster. Have to wonder how different this game might have been. Still an entire quarter left, though, but you have to wonder how different this game might have been without her impact. With her impact, that is. Almost lost it as Faith Thompson. That stop and pop is no good. Haley Baker long pass to Lavender Ward. 36 seconds left, and she is blocked, but she gets her own block back. Passing around the perimeter, Sal Charleston, Aaliyah Dunham. Ooh. Making people miss and scores. 65-27, 21 seconds left. GW on the move here. That is almost intercepted. Now that is, wow, turnover and an interception again by McMillan. McMillan drives in for two and scores and one. South Charleston up big here, but still Coach Green not happy with that one. Not happy with the effort here. 5.6 seconds left to go in the third quarter. She scores again, 65-30 for the Black Eagles. 4 seconds left. Let's see who shoots it here. Leah Dunham, stop and pop. That is no good. So at the end of the third quarter, bit of a laugher here. It's 65-30 in favor of the Black Eagles. We'll be right back after this quick commercial break. This is the RSN Sports Network.
Dynamic Physical Therapy and A-Game Performance Training offers Charleston's first and only physical therapy and sports performance facility. Whether you need rehabilitation or are looking to improve in your sport, focus on injury prevention, or just increase your strength and fitness, Dynamic Physical Therapy and A-Game Performance Training can give you the best outcome. In addition to our friendly and knowledgeable therapists and staff, come and experience high-level strength, conditioning, and performance training from nationally certified professionals in a brand new and exciting environment. Dynamic Physical Therapy and A-Game Performance Training are the formula for a better athlete and a better you.
You're watching a SCTV Network production.
And welcome back to the campus. Excuse me, that's for girls' game. This is a girls' game, however. Got me a little bit confused there. Welcome back to the South Charleston Community Center. As South Charleston with a 35-point lead over the rival, it's 65-30. GW gets the first possession of the quarter. They need to overcome a 35-point deficit here. Long three, no good. If they're going to overcome this deficit, that's how they're going to do it. They'll give the possession arrow to South Charleston after that jump ball. South Charleston's game last year in the MSAC Night of Champions, it was the conference championship versus Huntington. That was a much more exciting game. South Charleston trailed by 7 points at halftime but was able to come back, and the game came down to a last-second shot, buzzer beater by Aaliyah Dunham, and South Charleston got that win 63-61. Not as much excitement here for South Charleston's game this year. Long three, no good from McMillan, but GW gets their own rebound back and a reach in. Rhea Smith on the foul, that's her fourth. So not only GW, but South Charleston has a player in danger of foul trouble here. That is intercepted by Leah Dunham, and on the layup is good, 67-30. That's been about the story for the night. GW can't make a three-point shot. They turn over Leah Dunham on the fast break, or Lavender Ward, and another interception here, but GW gets it back. Sydney Mallory, she's in some foul trouble. She has four, and no foul there. That block is rejected, out of bounds. Rhea Smith comes out of the game here. Sydney Mallory with it. Long pass to McMillan. Back to Mallory. Mallory will shoot a three. She will make a three. Finally, some points for GW at 67-33, 6:40 left to go in this game. Haley Baker, now back to Leah Dunham. She thought about the shot but didn't take it. Lavender Ward, she's had a heck of a night, but not a good play that time. She tried to drive in but was, rejected out of bounds. Jayla Brown to inbound this one. She gets it to Haley Baker. She lays it in. 69-33 for the Black Eagles. This has been an even better game than previously seen in the regular season. Sydney Mallory with it. Passing around still, GW. McMillan. Long pass, nice football. reception by Sydney Mallory. Now to Faith Thompson. Faith Thompson out to Sydney Mallory. South Charleston in a 2-3 zone here. It's been effective all night. Faith Thompson for three, makes a three. So two threes in a row for GW here. It's 69-36. Leah Dunham with it. Haley Baker. Now Lavender Ward will drive in and score. What a game for Lavender Ward. 71-36 now for the Black Eagles. Into the center is Faith Thompson. And that is easily not much fight there. Aaliyah Dunham gets it. Aaliyah Dunham's teardrop shot is good. 73-36. Shea Watt's about to come into the game for South Charleston, as Coach Green has no sign of bringing in the substitutes so far. And GW's pass goes out of bounds. Another turnover. South Charleston gets back. Haley Baker comes out of the game. In comes Shea Watts. Aaliyah Dunham walking slowly up the court. Jayla Brown to Lavender Ward. To Aaliyah Dunham. She'll shoot a long three. She'll make a long three. That's from NCAA range, which is where she is heading to Xavier University. It's 76-36. Not the night for GW. They'll want to forget about this one. Oh, nice pick and roll by GW, but can't make the shot there. Lindsay Burdett is about to be subbed into the game for South Charleston. Passing around the perimeter. Long three from Dunham. That is good. They're leaving her wide open, 79-36. What a ugly blowout here for the first game of the Night of Champions. Faye Thompson from the foul line is no good. GW gets the rebound back and is fouled. Jayla Brown was the fouler on that play. Lauren Harmison, first shot is good. And in comes Lindsay Burdett for Lavender Ward. Lavender Ward getting her much-deserved break here. She's played extremely well. Another substitute for South Charleston, that's number 35, Rachel Walton. And she'll come in for number 41, Shea Watts. So Coach Green finally bringing in the substitutions here for South Charleston. Harmison's second shot is good. If you can say something nice about GW's performance, they have been excellent at the foul line. I can't remember any misses that they've had. Lindsay Burdett with it. Now to Brown, now to Dunham. Into Olivia Jeffries, her shot. Oh, in and out, no good. Sydney Mallory with it. Sydney Mallory. Now to McMillan. Long pass to the right wing, now top of the key for Mallory. Now to McMillan. McMillan will get it to Harmison, and she's fouled again. And a complete group substitution coming in here for GW. Basically conceding defeat here, I assume, as they're bringing all backups in. So let's see, 32, that is Keaton Broughton. Sorry about the pronunciation of that one. Also, number 30, Kaya Thompson. Number 34, Navara Harmon. Her first shot is good, very rare for GW. Also in for GW, number 20, Pive Randall. Her second shot is good, and the last substitution coming out for GW is all JV now. And number 40, Kim Carney comes in for number 44. That is Lauren Harmison. Another substitution. And out comes Aaliyah Dunham. In comes for the Black Eagles, number 31, Sam Carter Brown. So 3 minutes left. See if they try to focus on possession here. Lindsay Burdett with it. Lindsay Burdett to makes a girl miss. Now to Walton. Walton is pressured. Walton fighting through the contact. And GW gets that one. And that was a falsely called timeout there. That was a jump ball possession error to George Washington. Another substitute. I thought there was a substitute about to come in for South Charleston. Passing around the perimeter is GW with fresh legs. That three is good. It's too bad they couldn't have had that earlier in the game. 32, Broughton. Broughton, there we go. Nice pronunciation there. Broughton with the three. Olivia Jeffries with it. She'll shoot a three. She will not make that one. Fight for the rebound. Sam Carter-Brown under pressure gets the rebound. Now to Haley Baker. And South Charleston calls a timeout while they had possession. 30-second timeout. It's 2 minutes, 22 seconds left to go in this game. It's 79-41 in favor of the Black Eagles. We will be right back.
You're watching a SCTV Network production.
Packed with 9 essential nutrients, low-fat chocolate milk can be an important part of your recovery routine. Be sure to grab a chocolate milk after your next workout.
And welcome back to South Charleston Community Center. This is the MSAC Night of Champions. Olivia Jeffries' three is no good. And Sam Carter-Brown fighting for it, and she traveled. This is the girls' consolation game, the battle for third place between the rivals South Charleston and George Washington. And not much of a tight contest in this rivalry game this year. It's another substitute coming in for GW. Number 14, Tori Self, will come in. The only varsity player on the floor for GW right now. About 2 minutes left to go here. And a long three by Self is no good. And she gets her own rebound back. Passing around the perimeter back to Self. And ooh, that pass goes out of bounds over the head of Kaya Thompson. And a substitution for South Charleston. In comes Emily Given. And out comes Haley Baker. So it looks like we have all second string players onto the court for South Charleston. And not a very good play there. GW on the fast break scores. 1:36 left to go in this game. 79-43 is the score. GW fighting till the end. What you're seeing on the floor right now is a lot of the players you'll see next year, as we have 7 seniors graduating for the South Charleston Black Eagles. Jump ball possession to South Charleston. 1:24 left to go in this game. After this game, we will have the boys' consolation game, as I said, between the Huntington Highlanders and the Woodrow Wilson Flying Eagles. Rachel Walton with it. Now to Olivia Jeffries. Now to Given. Given lost that one. Nice pass there. Makes a man miss. And double dribble. Double dribble, that is, by GW. 1:06 left to go in this game. Let's see if South Charleston just tries to hold on to this one and get out of here with the big win over the rival and take the third place crown for the MSAC heading into sectionals. Long two by Walton. Excuse me, Burdett is good. That was Lindsay Burdett for the long two. It's 81-43. Long three from GW, no good. But Tori Self gets it back. Long three, no good. Rebounded by Sam Carter-Brown. 36 seconds left. See if they try to score a few more times or just hold on to this one. Rachel Walton out to Olivia Jeffries now. Now that shot is no good and by Emily Given. And still being tipped up into the basket, but GW gets it back. 15 seconds left. Maybe one more shot for Pride here by GW. They do it. They're fouled on that shot. So 11.3 seconds left to go in this game. Going to try to drag this one on for as long as possible, it seems, as she will go to the line to shoot two. Kaya Thompson's first shot is good. Second shot up and good. 81-45. Let's see if that'll be the final score here. South Charleston might get one more shot off here. 4 seconds left. Lindsay Burdett drives in. Did they get the shot off? No, but that doesn't really matter. And your third place winner for the MSAC this year is the South Charleston Black Eagles. They defeat their bitter rival, the George Washington Patriots, 81-45 here in the first game of the MSAC Night of Champions. Not the best game to watch. There's a much closer game going on in Morgantown right now. We'll get you that score at the beginning of the second game we have coming up. That's between the Huntington Highlanders and the Woodrow Wilson Flying Eagles. So, as I said, 81-45 for the Black Eagles. Nice score going into sectionals. So, we will be back in about, 45 minutes for the beginning of the second game. This is the RSN Sports Network. We will see you then.